If a cow eats strawberries, do they make strawberry milk? This might sound like a dumb question, but you'll be surprised to know that a cow's diet affects the flavor of its milk. More surprisingly, the same concept rings true with women who are lactating. Studies show it only takes 1 hour to make banana-flavored breast milk, 2 hours for licorice-flavored milk, and if you've got 8 hours to kill, you can make menthol-flavored breast milk. Today, we're talking to a friend of the show, Dr. Karl Kruszelnicki, about the science of human-flavored breast milk and how it could be beneficial for children.
You eat a chemical, and the chemical then goes into your mouth, into your gut, into your bloodstream, into the liver, unchanged, into the bloodstream, and then appears in the breast milk.
Historically, it was thought that a child's character was influenced by breast milk and a woman's experience during pregnancy. Rumor has it that in the 1800s, people were super careful about choosing a wet nurse. They thought her personality, intelligence, and speech patterns could be transferred to the child through the breast milk. Also, studies dating back to the 60s have tried to examine a link between a child's mental illness and their mom's diet. Milk production begins in women during pregnancy, when milk-producing cells multiply and milk ducts grow. The process enables the body to extract chemicals from blood and synthesize them. The mammary glands then add some water to the mix, and out comes a substance mostly made of salt water, fats, proteins, and carbohydrates. The substance is capable of sustaining life from 0 to 6 months, while also boosting the child's immune system through the release of antibodies. But when it comes to flavoring, that depends on what you eat. Food chemicals can flow through the body and be directly passed into breast milk unchanged. So if you're eating strawberries, it's possible for you to produce strawberry-flavored milk. Those food flavoring chemicals can also be changed by the body during the metabolic process, creating a totally different flavor. This concept of natural flavoring was first tested in cows, but the same effect is known to happen in humans.
And they discovered, the scientists, that if they fed them a mixture of oats and sunflower, they end up with raspberry milk. But they didn't give them any raspberry flavoring. So what happened was that the oats stimulated the growth of certain bacteria in the gut of the cow, and then these bacteria, present there in huge numbers, then decided to start eating the sunflower seeds, and they converted the sunflower seeds into an oil called, I'm looking it up here, gamma-dodec cis-6-enolactone. And that chemical tastes so much like raspberries that it's there not just in the milk of the cows, but in the meat if the cows get slaughtered.
Wonder what's the purpose of all of this flavoring? Well, researchers say it could influence your child's behavior. Studies show that when lactating women eat food like garlic, it causes babies to latch on and feed for longer. As adults, our food choices are based partly on genetics and on our environment. So a variety of breast milk flavors could prime children's taste buds, making them more likely to eat a wider variety of food. A 1999 study showed that infants were more prone to like carrot-flavored cereal if their mom drank a lot of carrot juice while breastfeeding. So there's a decent chance if your kid doesn't like broccoli, kale, or zucchini, it's because you don't like them either. In case you're wondering about alcohol, let's just say it can change the taste of your breast milk, but it won't get your child buzzed unless you drink extreme amounts.
It will show up in the breast milk, but not enough to make the baby drunk. Because if you do the numbers, assuming that you're getting drunk at around 0.05, where your judgment in driving a car begins to fall off, the volume of alcohol that the mother would have to drink would be so much so that she'd be well and truly unconscious before she even got to 0.01. Because it firstly goes into the bloodstream, and then from the bloodstream then has to go into the breast milk, and the amount that the baby would be getting would be very small. People do say that the baby tends to sleep a little bit more if the mother has had a little bit of alcohol. But once again, I'm putting that in the anecdote rather than data file.
Now, you know I couldn't leave without a fun fact, right? It's worth noting that babies aren't the only ones who drink breast milk. Breast milk is rich in nutrients and antibodies, so it's finding a new home with bodybuilders and athletes as an alternative to steroids. Breast milk is not sold in Walmart, but it's easily accessible on the World Wide Web, where moms sell excess milk for as little as 99 cents an ounce. So with all that said, we have learned that a mom's diet is pivotal to the flavoring of breast milk. It could take as little as 1 hour for breast milk to be flavored, and the flavoring can last up to 8 hours. When breastfeeding, doctors recommend you eat plenty of protein, calcium, and iron. But don't forget those veggies, as it could be a major influence on whether or not your child likes them too. Hey guys, thanks for watching this week's episode of What the Facts. Hope you enjoyed. If you did, make sure you hit the like button and subscribe to our channel. Got a weird body science question? Shoot your shot, drop a comment below, and who knows, we might cover it. Be sure to catch more of this season every Tuesday.